week, the NDA government led by Prime Minister Modi completes 4 years at the helm. It's a significant year because for the next 12 months in the run-up to Lok Sabha elections, this government will be closely scrutinized on all its promises, especially ones like Housing for All by 2022. Welcome to Urban Reality. I'm Anisha Natarajan, and today we take you through not just what's been achieved on the housing mission, but also the larger housing market of India and the impact some key steps like DIMON and RERA have had on it. The three big questions we are asking: is Housing for All by 2022 on track? What are the actual figures on the ground, considering the Ministry of Housing has advanced the cut-off date of the mission to 2020? Our second question: what is the private sector's contribution to making affordable homes? And the final question: can affordable housing revive India's flagging housing market? It's taken a big beating post-demonetization and RERA. Joining me today on the show, Sanjay Dutt, Tata Housing and Development MD and CEO. We also have with us Rajiv Talwar, Chairman Naredco and CEO of DLF, and Neeraj Bansal, Partner and Head of Real Estate. Before that, though, let me set the stage for the discussion, gentlemen, with the latest figures the government has achieved on its 1 crore plus home targeted for urban India under the mission. So earlier, I caught up with the Housing Secretary, Durga Shankar Mishra, to get the latest statistics. Here are the numbers from him.
Well, so far, we have already sanctioned nearly 46 lakhs houses. Out of that, 7 lakhs houses are already complete. And work is already, they have been grounded and under construction nearly 25 lakhs houses.
So 7 lakh completed units, which is just about 7% of the target, which is 1 plus crore homes. That begs the second question: what has been the private sector's contribution to this mission? According to data sourced from PropEquity, a leading research firm, all private companies put together have launched, look at that number, only 45,000 units in under 25 lakh rupee bracket, which is the affordable segment, for the year 2017, despite the government floating 8 schemes for PPP. My next question to Mr. Mishra was, is there a way that the government can accelerate private participation?
Well, private sector is coming. In fact, initially they were not coming forth very eagerly. But we made certain policy changes. Let me tell you a few. For example, private housing normally comes, does not come within the city, but outside the city, which is called the development area. We have allowed, earlier, we were allowing housing only within the city limits. But we have now allowed in the development area, which is actually rural area, but already development plan is there. And the housing is being regulated. Two, we also allowed in, say, all kinds of development authorities or industrial development authorities, port development authorities, or any kind of development authority where the land is regulated. So this has expanded the whole thing. Number two, initially under the credit link subsidy scheme, the total area for the MIG1 and MIG2 was only 90 and 110 square meter. That has been increased to 120 and 150 square meter. That makes it affordable. The third, in the last budget, finance minister has given certain concessions. Honorable finance minister in his speech has created an affordable housing fund, which is going to reduce the interest burden on the those who are purchasing houses under the affordable housing scheme. Then also this has been given infrastructure status, that is also getting certain benefits. The scheme of CLSS has been, which was there only up to 2018, that had been increased to March 2019. All these factors, it is in my knowledge that though we have sector sanctioned very few schemes under with affordable housing with the partnership of the private sector, one in Maharashtra, but now many more are coming. Now even the states have advertised using those 8 model which we have developed. They have advertised, and the private sector is coming in a big way. And it is they keep contacting me, and whatever problems they have, those problems are being sorted out.
All right, Sanjay Dutt, the first question to you. 8 models, and I think a lot of the demands which the industry had for affordable housing have all been met. Infrastructure status, CLSS scheme, expanded to cover 150 square meters, and of course, you know, several PPP models. Mr. Mishra says private sector is coming. Is it coming?
First of all, Manisha, we have to acknowledge that this government, right from the beginning, has done a lot for the real estate sector and, of course, also for affordable homes in the last few years. So that's commendable. Yes, we know that the jurisdiction on land resides with state governments, and many state governments have also made a lot of effort, and Maharashtra government, West Bengal government, and many other state governments have actually taken initiatives. However, given the scale and size of this gap, obviously it will take time to meet such a large target, and there that can only happen if the private sector comes in. The private sector was largely focusing and was distracted by other segments which were investor-led, speculator-led, and premium housing-led, and they have recently only shifted their focus. However, at Tata Housing, we actually started our journey much earlier doing Tata Value Homes across Maharashtra, across Tamil Nadu, and Karnataka, and we've been very successful, and we have a very large inventory that we've delivered, and much more is coming and is taking shape and getting finalized. However, we may not have done enough, and we intend to do more. We're looking at affordable housing, just as many other developers are, and it's going to take time, Manisha, whether mm-hmm. we are able to deliver by 2020. But the reality is everybody wants to cater to end user, and this segment is an end user, and it's the largest segment for the developers to concentrate.
All right.
But it's going to take time.
It's going to take time, but developers are coming. Rajiv Talwar, as the chairman of Naredco, is that your understanding? You know, 8 models, demand, pent-up demand. Was it because the sector was distracted, as Sanjay Dutt has rightly put, chasing that segment of speculators and investors, all in for properties above 50 lakh and maybe in crores? Was that the reason which has prevented them from making any meaningful contribution in 2017, sir?
Partially the reasons as given by Sanjay, but not a total picture. The truth was that yes, there has been a slowdown. There has been a global meltdown, slowdown in India. But the truth is that people were going where money was being invested into, whether by the end buyer or whether by speculators and investors. Then comes the problem that every private sector developer is to account for the cost of land. And in very many cities, that was the critical factor which led to a spike in the prices of homes. With now the present government giving a lot of incentives which have been listed out by the Secretary of Urban Development and Housing, plus also what the present minister has done, those 8 models were announced in his first meeting in Mumbai. He's also got 60,000 crores. And the target is 4 crore homes, Manisha. So 4 crore homes is no small number, but he's advanced the target to something like 2020 instead of 2022. There are schemes which are being done by the NBCC. There are schemes between 18 lakhs or below by the private sector, because in many states, state governments have taken not only the responsibility, but given incentives like increasing FAR, which has been done recently in Mumbai also. They've also done it in the states of Delhi, in the states of Haryana, and other state governments, that they have tried to bring down the price of land to as close as zero as possible. How have they done it? They've given extra FAR mm-hmm. and said that you have to make a mandatory 15 to 20% for every upscale housing project being undertaken. So I think to that extent, yes, the private sector stepping in. You also have state public sector undertakings like the NBCC, which is going in a big way to now redevelop colonies. We've seen it in Delhi. We've seen the railways do it in Delhi. And I'm sure these models are going to be replicated all over the country.
Okay.
You especially have towns which are railway junctions okay. and where normally the story has been only a single-storied building, But now they can go in for high rise as much as 10 to 20 stories. And we at NAREDCO have even assured the Prime Minister's office that should they require plans, good for construction building plans for any building size, which is a single floor, double floor, four floors, 8 to 10 floors, or even up to 20 floors for buildings and homes and apartments of anything
right.
of 300 square feet, 350 square feet, 650 square feet, that is 30 meters, 60 meters, 90 meters, 120 and including 150, we are most happy to make them available so that there is no time lag between sanctions of individual projects. If these good for construction drawings and as many models can be put on the net, they should be allowed to be undertaken by state governments and local bodies straight
okay.
off the drawing board.
All right.
And
so good
regular
to know,
inspections
Mr. Talwar,
can now make up for the time
NAREDCO,
lag which was taken for
okay.
approvals.
Okay. So I'm hearing positive things and that's very good. Neeraj Garg, step in here. I mean, finally, every participant till last debate that I've done on affordable housing has been all about how it still doesn't make sense for private participants to come in for affordable housing. And let's just differentiate here. 50 lakhs is not affordable housing, the segment that we are talking about. It has to be under 25 lakh rupees. In fact, the ministry says that the segment they're talking about is really under 15. But let's not argue about that. Under 25 lakh. Good to hear that private sector is now enthused about it. Do you believe that this number or 2020 mission, which has been advanced by the Housing Ministry itself, is a target which will be met?
So from a government point of view, like, you know, Sanjay and Rajiv both mentioned, I think they've done a lot of, policy changes over the last 3 years, 4 years around it. And with, the fact that there's so many multiple authorities in the sector who are engaged, and land being a local subject as well from a state point of view, real estate is highly regulated, highly challenging environment for private developers to step in and make changes into the business models, and also be able to, get business margins out of it, so it's kind of changing, flipping the business model totally, so government, if you look at it from the government point of view or the ministry point of view, I think that the focus is to say that they are talking about 1 crore houses. They are talking about sanctioning, the 40, 47, 46 lakhs, as you mentioned around it, Mr. Mishra mentioned. So the government has kind of categorically pushed the government bodies to actually deliver those houses, and beneficiary-led construction is a very significant component going to be out of those 1 crore houses, which will get delivered, as part of the government's mission right now for the 1 crore houses around it. Private sector participation was due to come in, will take time, it is taking time. One needs to flip the business model, understand the implications of the, various policies and the regular changes that are being brought into them as well. And the land cost continues to be a major component of that. So when you say under 15 lakh houses, the land is the biggest component, as part of that cost. And if you just put it outside of the city limits, it is not livable, So while it may be affordable, but it is not something which is well connected. It is affordable from a point of view of, the economic activity aspect of it. So under 15 lakh houses, while the government number for 1 crore itself is, I would say that, achievable from a sanctioning perspective, but to get those houses up and running, they would require more mobilization of the government agencies to actually build those houses up as well and
okay.
get them occupied,
okay.
also on that.
All right. Fair point that at least the numbers of sanction, and there is of course a target of 4 crore homes if you include rural India, but for urban India where you feel the maximum pinch, the target is a crore plus. Now, gentlemen, I'm going to just run through certain other figures and expand the conversation to India's residential market in 2017. As far as affordable is concerned, seems that the government is on track. Maybe a little late on actual end product, but at least on sanctioning, it seems that it will meet the targets. What else happened in this government period? Now, note ban happened and RERA happened, and it was a complete knockout for India's residential market. Top 14 cities saw a 71% dip in new units launched since its peak of 2010. 44% dip in new units absorbed, and unsold stock climbed to 8 lakh units. Inventory overhang was at 50 months. This is about 2017. You have now a slew of new launches being announced. not in terms of numbers, but whatever's coming is all coming in the affordable segment, which is under 50 lakh rupees. The question I want answered from my panelists after this break is, will this affordable housing mantra bring the mojo back to India's residential sector? Stay with us.